So the topic that I'm going to present today is creating a reusable Vue.js component library. And a quick introduction about myself. I'm Divyam Rastogi. I'm a senior application engineer at Flog, and I've got 6 years of front-end development experience. So the problem statement that I, the problem that I faced was that most organizations, they have a design language of their own. That they have some primary, secondary colors and some components that have a very distinctive look and feel. So what happens is that like you tend to have like components like these. So you've got form elements, you've got buttons, and so on. So this is a very just one page from our style guide. And the thing is that like we tend to have like we tend to have duplicate code when it comes to like writing components across apps, across dashboards. So so the problem with multiple dashboards and web applications is that they end up like looking alike for a, for an organization. But at the same time, we tend to copy paste those components. Like, for example, some like I used to do that too. And what we would do is we'll just copy some component from one repo and then paste it into another. So the problem with that is that like, say you've got three repos and you copy pasted the same component in, into those three repositories. And then you suddenly realize that there is a bug in one of those, like in all three of those repositories. And when you fix that bug, you get to fix that everywhere. You get to like fix it, push the code in all three repositories, and then what happens is that like you're basically doing a lot more. So this is an excerpt from an article I wrote about like why I built a component library, and like I wanted to point out the highlighted portion. This was the most highlighted portion on medium.com from that article. It says that there was a need for all UI components to be consistent with the theme and colors of the application. Having pre-built components which adhere to the design theme would make development much faster and definitely more fun. So that is the reason I built a component library for Flock and using Vue.js. So what do you say to duplicate code? Like every time you think that, okay, I'm going to copy this code and paste it into another repository, what should you say? Not today. This is definitely what you should say. So is it hard to create your own library like using Vue? Using Vue CLI? Well, without Vue CLI, it's actually a little bit harder, meaning that you'll have to configure your build process using Webpack or Rollup or whatever you want to use. And then you'll have to like manage a lot of things on your own. So without the Vue CLI, it is a bit hard. But with Vue CLI, it's not as hard. So that is what I wanted to like talk to you about today. So where do we start about like building, how do we start building these components and this component library that we keep talking about? We start by writing our components, and where do we like start writing those components? It's in a project that we create using Vue CLI. So is that it? Well, let's just see. So step one is to create your components, and there are like, there are some concerns while creating your own components, right? Like you need to make sure that you're making them extensible, but at the same time, you don't want to over-engineer them. Like you don't want to over-engineer for cases that you might never encounter, right? So make them extensible so that if you want to change them later, it should not be as hard. And preferably write unit tests, because in case like you're unknowingly breaking a core feature of your component, then that unit test should tell you what that you're breaking something. So like there is a tool called Storybook, and you could explore that as well. Storybook enables you to run your it runs alongside your development environment, and then you can basically use Storybook to build standalone components aside from your whole development process. And accessibility. So there is a web AIM accessibility checklist that you want to make sure that your components work for people who are visually challenged as well. So this is a checklist that, and there's a link here. You could check that out. So this is an example of a link component. And I know I've been talking about accessibility, and this component is definitely not accessible right now. And it's just a simple SFC, a simple Vue SFC. And this is just a very basic example. So the step two is to export your files through an entry point. This is a very important step because this is where the Vue CLI will know that these are the components that you're going to be exporting. And so basically what you could do is you could have an index.js in your source and export all components using the snippet that like is visible here. Step three is basically setting up your library build process. You could just change your NPM build script to Vue CLI service build and give it a target as lib. Basically, this tells the Vue CLI to build the component library in lib mode, build it in the lib mode. And you get to give it a name as well and an entry point. So this is the same entry point that we talked about here. And the output will look something like this. So we're going to talk about the common JS module here, and that's what I'm going to show you in an example as well. So the step four is that you have to package your stuff, right? Like you have to tell how Vue.js will find how when you're using your library, how the user will find that particular file. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to add an attribute files to your package.json, which is an array of strings. And these files are the ones that will get exported when you publish your package to either NPM or Yarn. So you also have to add your name to the library, the name field of package.json, because that is where that is what will be visible on the NPM repository. So the entry point is the build, the bundle that you built here, because we're going to talk about CommonJS here. And this is how you import your component, and then you use it like a regular component in Vue. So how do you publish your library? Well, you have to you could preferably write a script to publish your library, like a shell script, a simple shell script that basically does the following. You have to publish it in public mode so that everyone you want can use the library. And this command will publish your library to NPM. But first you'll have to definitely create a user on NPM. You could do that using NPM add user, or if you already have an NPM account, you could do NPM login into the terminal and then publish this. So you could actually integrate this whole thing into a build process as well, on a build machine, on a build process like GoCD perhaps, and then all of this gets automated. So how do you use your library? All you need to do is just install it from NPM, like NPM I, and save as a dependency and the name of your library. So install it as usual and use the component as you'd normally use a Vue component. So, but there are limitations when it comes to Vue CLI right now. On-demand loading is not currently supported when it comes to the CommonJS bundle. And but this can be overcome by using something called Lerna. Lerna is a tool for managing JavaScript projects with multiple packages. What you'll be doing basically when you use Lerna is you'll be publishing your link component as a separate library itself, as a separate component itself. And if you have a custom select as well, then you'll be publishing it as another component. And then you'll get to use it like the usual way. So semantic versioning, let's talk about semantic versioning. Basically, if you're making breaking changes, if you're making major changes, just bump up the version of your library, like the first decimal. And that's how you end up with semantic versioning. If you're making minor changes, just bump up the second decimal or the third decimal. Another limitation is that assets like SVGs, they have to be inlined with your into your Vue components because currently VueCLI does not support that, support getting images from your folders. So these are some tools, Lerna and Storybook. You can build monorepos using Lerna. Using Storybook, you can build your components independently and test them out. So any questions and answers now? All right. When you say web and the mobile, do you mean a mobile application or do you mean the mobile web?
Mobile application.
Okay, you want to use it on the mobile application. Okay. It should ideally work the same way as you're using it on the web, because the Vue ecosystem allows that. Like, you can have, you're probably talking about web views, when you're building a mobile app, are you talking about web views or are you talking about native web apps?
Native web
apps. Okay, native web apps. Okay. I'm not entirely sure about native web apps at this point, so I don't think I'll be able to answer that.
Okay, no problem.
Hi.
Other solutions for creating libraries are difficult. Is there some other that picked up your interest some that you would definitely not recommend for those who are wondering to choose other options? You mentioned that there are other solutions that we could use to create our library, and other than VueCLI, are there solutions that you tried yourself and were more or less satisfied with, or some that you would definitely not recommend, based on your experience?
Okay, so if you have a really small library, maybe 10-12 components in the library size, does not exceed 30 kb's diesel, then I would directly use VueCLI for that. But if we have a library of components that is huge in number, for example, if we're building something like material design components and your organization has that use case, then you could use Lerna to build monorepos. So what Lerna does is it publishes all components with their own versions onto NPM. So that you could automate that, and that could solve that use case as well. Does that answer your question?
So you said with VueCLI, can we have single component library and use it for multiple projects? It's plugin and
Exactly. Oh. That is what a library can be used for. Is the main use case.
But we cannot use it on a scaled or a component which a large size of components, which you said.
If you have many, many components, then the CommonJS bundle will become big, and that will reduce your first load time.
Oh,
ideally, that is not advised if you have a lot of components. But But if you have a very few number of components, like for my case, my maximum library size has been around 20 GB.
Oh, okay.
So I was fine with that. Behind you.
Have you worked with nested libraries of any kind? Like you have built components in a library and
right.
then you compose them onto a upper level component
right.
and then automated the build process so that everything gets updated.
That's fairly simple. Like if you have, you could even have nested components. I'll add a link to the repository that I built. We have a modal component that is using composition from another generic modal component, and I'm using composition to make that component, and it is in the library as a component itself. So both of them, generic modal and modal, they're both components, and they can be used from the library itself. So yeah, it is possible.
Okay, we can take one more question. Anyone?
So as you said, like we can have small components and we can, if they are smaller in numbers,
yeah.
like 10, 15, 20.
Yeah.
But what if like 10, 20, 15 components we have, they are big, not small components like button use,
okay.
Users show.
Okay. If they're like bigger in size,
yeah.
not just small components. So
yeah.
usually base components are small in size. In my experience, but if you have bigger components, you could like Lerna is for you. Lerna will resolve your use case. So you can check that out. Lerna is a really good tool. I recently discovered it like when we were reviewing our presentation. So like my ex-colleague told me about Lerna, and that's how I came to know about it. So yeah, Lerna is good. All right.
Based on experience from the existing libraries, which one piqued your interest the most? Which one made you most impressed if we are talking about the build process, the custom build process created specifically for those libraries?
Okay, so right now, as of now, there aren't a lot of libraries for you. For Vue.js, there have been a few libraries now, since 2019. But so I haven't actually had a look at a lot of libraries, but I've used material design for Vue. So and there is a library built by Chris Fritz. He had published it on GitHub, and that was a really good starting point for me. Like, I really learned a lot by looking at his code. So, yeah.